And it seems to me sometimes when you learn something new, it's like a very fresh and fun thing. And the moment you get used to that, and then you get to a boredom stage where you just don't enjoy it. And then you look for new ways of stimulating yourself and doing different techniques and so on. And that's fresh and novel for a while. And then if it's reach another plateau, it seems to go on with that.
Yeah.
So I was wondering if this practice also at some stage might help. You might be useful.
But what I really think is important, and I think it's very accurate, what I really think is important in what you're saying is that it's not that the practice has become boring per se, because it's infinitely creative, but you could do Aikido infinitely creative. Kino Nagari Aikido could go on forever. The point is that as you pay attention more, and that's what I was saying, listen to the whisperings, you start to hear and feel things about you've never heard and felt before, even in the same quote-unquote same technique. You don't think you need to change partners all the time because you're married or something, but you have your life excited. The reason that it gets like that is that you shut your senses and say, oh, I know this one already, and you stop paying attention. You stop seeking in that person aspects that you've never seen before. And you stop seeking in yourself in relationship to them, aspects you've never seen before, and the relationship becomes boring, and the technique becomes boring, the art becomes boring, and life becomes boring. And then you go and you see a new scene yourself, oh, and you open up your senses again, you start to experience in a way that's, there's more stimulation, you're more alive, more vibrant, more enhancing. So, I don't mean to be misunderstood, which, how can you help it? In that, it's the making it different, or doing, oh, because if this is boring, we just go do karate next week. Or we have to do a different technique every time, it won't be fun. You know that you've done sometimes, 40 techniques in a row, and after a while they start to, kind of slows down, and then they do start to get more interesting. And you open on a new vista or something like that. But what's happened is that you've held in your mind that there's something that you haven't noticed yet. There's something that you have yet to learn about this. That makes it exciting. And I guarantee you, I don't care what it is, there's something yet that you could learn about it. From cooking and lovemaking to martial arts and business to art and traveling. There's new stuff going on everywhere. The question is, we start to go down that track, pretty soon, you know how it is. The engineer doesn't watch the track anymore, he doesn't do much anymore, he knows it. You know what I mean? He kind of keeps an eye out, but puts less and less attention until it turns out to be a boring thing. It takes some severe discipline to be an engineer and down that track and say, what am I missing? I wonder what's going on down this line that I've never noticed before. At the same time, I would agree, once you've opened up that spirit, how fascinating it is to get off the track and slow the rest of you. Without that spirit, that same stupid attitude, getting off the track doesn't do anything. Going to a new country doesn't do anything. Finding a new lover doesn't do anything. You end up with the same stinking problem. Wherever you go, there you are. So it's the way that you engage in the universe that we're experimenting with here. I'm not teaching you moves. Oh, I talk to you. Who cares? Maybe I remember what I said about Shimonaga this morning. This is more important, isn't it? I mean, there really isn't any question about that. And not to knock that, probably was good. It helped you pay more attention to your experience. That's all I'm really here about. I'm not here to teach you. I'm here to teach you. I'm here to learn with you. So I'll share what I know, and you bounce back, and you think together. And this might be the best class I've ever taught. Certainly been one of the most exciting for me. Okay? So I'm going to spend a few more minutes and see if we can keep opening up our senses to what we think we already know. Something more of them. What are we missing? What more could I notice? What's happened that I've never thought of, or never sensed, or never paid attention to before? Pay attention to what you pay for. I saw him again. It's like he knew he was had, and why fight it? That's what she wants you to go down and go there. Anybody else find something that just stuck them, or that was so interesting that you'd share it with us just out of curiosity?
Well, I found that the head is so slow, that just cool, you just grab the feet. You don't have to do something with the feet because if your hands are stuck or something, the head is right or wrong.
Yes,
that's
just
that's just the problem with yourself.
Thank you.
You
can
just
go
with the
ego. Yeah, as a matter of fact, kind of on the converse of that, it's like when someone starts berating you, it's like saying, again, just offer no resistance. Now, if you argue with them, the argument can go on for years, and you know people like that.
Pretty solid. One nice thing I found was a number of times a connection was made with strike, and I didn't have any sort of negative feeling about it at all. It was okay. So, it was wonderful.
You know, in life you're going to take some hits. There's no reason to give up and mope. Let's bring the circle in just a little bit. Again, you know, my preference is everybody can see everybody. It's kind of how I guide myself. But are we in the right place? And what I'd like to do is play with spontaneity and authenticity. We've gone around the circle once, several times. I'd like to go around the circle three times. Partially, just so that you can see what.
Yeah. And all of a sudden it goes to REC.
Record.
So now it is actually recording.
Oh, yes.
So there's a gap.
And stop. Yeah.
And when you hit the button.
In the area we've been playing, but I guess I'd like to share out loud with you if you want to just sit comfortable for a second. Number one, I spoke with Clyde for a minute. I don't know, mostly you know Johan, who was missing, was Gramps, you know. Taught a lot of these guys. And I think put out a lot of beautiful spirit into the art and it's sort of withdrawn from the art at this point. And my sense now, from a lack of a sense of support, something like that. And I think sometimes when we start to teach, and you know, there are a lot of things that get in the way. I might very much appreciate your honesty when you came out to start this class. That we start to put all this stuff on ourselves as teachers. And then of course students see that. And so they think, oh, that's Aikido. You can't set them on you. You just start putting a lot of stuff on yourself. But for the teachers especially, there's a kind of pressure that we put on ourselves that can be very debilitating. And I think it weighed very heavy on Johan. And so after Clyde and I spoke about it, I thought possibly those of you who teach might, maybe at the end of this class, maybe we might like to sit for 20 minutes or so and talk about some of these issues. Now, if that would interest you, I would say let's do that. And what I would say is that those of you who are junior, if you'd like to, I'm going to focus with the teachers on this one. But I would invite you to come and sit outside, but around us, and in the family, even though you might be in the next ring now. I don't mean to exclude you, but I do need to give focus to the teachers in the sense that I think that those of you who are sharing your teaching with these people are critical. Because without them, y'all wouldn't have a way to train. In this vein, I spoke to some of you, about how impressed I am with what I've seen. Your teaching, I think, is excluded. And not because you're such excellent Aikidoists, but because you're students, because you're excellent students. And I don't think you can model a better tone for the students themselves if you can get out and do things wrong. So the students feel they can do things wrong. Because if you can't do things wrong, you can't do anything. And if you can't, you can't learn. In other words, you can't do a bad Nikyo, since you don't know how to do a good Nikyo, you just can't train. You've got to be able to make mistakes, and it's important that the teachers model that. And the teachers model their learning process. And also the beauty and the gentleness and the feeling that you all show. I'm really, really pleased to see it. Just really just touched by it. I thought each of you did something very lovely. And those of you who study these people, I know you're probably equal to nothing. But I just want to know that, maybe you've seen some of the other styles of teaching where they don't have that kind of interest, they don't put forward that kind of inquiry, they don't have that kind of support to learn. the teachers need to know that you appreciate them. It doesn't mean you have to come up and say, oh, I love you, I would pray. It means that you find ways to help out, even if showing up to sweep the dojo. That says something. It says I care. It says thank you. So I don't know what the ways are. Maybe you buy them a beer once in a while. Maybe you do say thank you once in a while. Maybe you're just polite and attentive in class. I don't know. Maybe you spread the word to other people and bring people to dojo. There's a lot of ways that you can support the process even if you're not a teacher. But like I said, it's 5 when I came down last time, the teaching and the quality of the art was much, much more mechanical. Whatever this feeling and flowing and whatever seems to have been sending to a much greater degree, now I'm sitting in this group. If I sat in another group, I might not feel this way, I don't know. But I'd like to acknowledge all of you who shared your teaching. Like I said, we'll see what I can do tomorrow. And really thinking about me. And that I guess so, maybe after this class we'll sit for a while. All those who would like to sit nearby and join in either way, please do so. I think that maybe we could do just a moment or two of where we were calling the one. And just, let me set it up this way. So we'll do the same thing. He attacks whatever he wants, I move whenever I want. And we'll go that far and again. Just so we have that sense that it doesn't stop after the first move, let's go a little bit further. Okay? Thank you. We did it. So, same basic, something new. But before we do, would you all stand up for a minute? And walk around the mat. Walk. The mat will walk.
I'm not just having fun, of course. I'm not just having fun.
Went slow, it was more difficult to maintain your focus on the attack. Mm-hmm. And hang on just a second, just go slow. Maybe what started to happen was your focus wasn't wrong. You were resisting, oh my focus is shifting. Maybe you're opening up to a greater field, so I'm not sure, it might be good. Let's not be too quick to judge, that's all. It could be something nice going on, I don't know.
I like the fact that you can stop and start to think about what you're going to do.
It's difficult to think, how can you think that slowly?
Yeah. I think it's difficult to do most of
it. Yeah, I felt very connected to my partner, even though we were quite a distance apart. There was still a lot of movement, and even coming out of the new kidney, nothing stopped at all, but it's really lovely, and also a connection to the world.
I feel like really enjoying myself.
Shooting.
Keeping contact, keeping the awareness, keeping the movement, don't divorce the two.
Yeah, this connection over the distance or something like that, you know, you should be able to feel it across the bar. Right? That sense, or you know, as soon as they're thinking about you, something in you should start to tingle. They might be, you know, miles away, and you're starting to get some sense of something. Don't they do these things where they do these circles and they heal someone across the continent or something? They send healing energy to someone across the continent? Do you believe in that kind of stuff? The connection's there. It's just that our attention is usually on our bank account or wherever she is, or, you know, a new car or, you know, whatever. The activity of the moment, the pool game.
When you say the activity of the moment, you mean the activity of the moment?
Yeah, I mean whatever we're consciously paying attention to at the moment, we start to narrow down on. You know, watch anybody in a group attack. What they kind of do is one, and then the other, and then the other. Well, Sensei said, train with one as if there were many, and train with many as if there were one. I don't know what it means either, but let it wash over you and see what I got to.
to a flow. Yeah, maybe we'll stop. Okay, groups of three about that speed. So, the intent of Mike at this point is he should have an attack coming towards me. Now, maybe he moves slow enough, you know, depending on my level or ability, slow enough that it's not a problem for me. But let's go over Mike for a second here. So I don't cut key as the second uke. And then I start in. Then kind of cut key. And then I. Alright? And so that the nage is receiving. One more second here. One more. The nage is receiving, even though I'm kind of waiting until I can get a safe opening. My key is still on and he feels me coming on the approach. Understand? What did they get you once in a while? It's okay. It's okay. You don't have to be quite as they usually are. Don't speed up. Slow. The intention is to come get me even while I'm dealing with me. That's it. Good. You don't have to wait, you can't. Go ahead.
if I'm connected with you in qi, and you speed up, I will speed up. But it looks like it got me a million times, but it's not that bad. So, and even once in a while, you know, yeah, it could be a lot more fun. Life could be a lot more fun and a lot less of a worry than we usually make it. And oh yeah, we're going slow. Well, all the more reason to show you that why you're doing it now. Well, it's because it's your habit. If you continue to develop this habit, you'll get better. If you change your habit, you'll open a new doorway for yourself. Okay? Yeah, I know you're burned. Let's go one more round here, then I'll change the game a bit. But see if you can't keep that going. And if you're tired, because you're going too fast, and you don't blame me, I tried to tell you. Please, very slow, very relaxed. Really playful, easy. Let them get you once in a while. See what happens then. You'll learn something from those mistakes, those bad ones. And even if your mind doesn't, your body does. Right?
Started, you know, got a lot invested. Now we're really committed. And we never cared in the first place.
So it's kind of a... And there's a place...
Well, my mother pushed me.
And the harder they push, the more I set it up. And then we start to get these kinds of openings, and we'll be back into the move again. And that's what happens as soon as they start to close in. Now, really, we're looking for that to happen in energy, where we kind of feel the pressure of their energy. But we're so busy doing this, I thought, one more time, a couple of minutes, give everybody four turns. Give everybody four turns. Just hang out. So there's a lot of pressure in your life. What do you think? You're special or something? He's a great fighter, he's a really tough, he's a pit bull. you got to kill this guy to stop him. And he's black belt in judo, and he's practically black belt in karate. And, you know, he's trained, and he's tough, and he's mean, and he's hard, and he's on his back in the middle of the mat. He said it was like he was throwing out a club. He didn't feel a thing. He felt, maybe he felt like a fingertip on his forehead. That was the closest thing he had to anything he had won. He said, I've never been that so hard. He got out of the suit with a smile. So, a couple of those kinds of stories. I have heard a few others. Terry Dobson, too, the other guest, told some great stories about us. But, you know, it just, if you look at it, you just go, you know, it's the kids. Because it's so insane. There's one great one where he's open hand, and, you know, they're all bigger than me. You know, look like, you know, bigger than Mike is than me, you know. And you can't even see him for a second. He just completely disappears. And then, you know, all of a sudden they're all standing on the floor and he says, it's like this. I got to meet a guy who was, I read the article of a guy who was at the Japanese police station when they asked Osensei to come in. And he had five people. He lay down on his back, put one on each arm, one on each leg, and the guy sitting on his chest, choking. You know, and then their story was like, you know, being blown off. His body turned to iron and just thrown off. So it got to a level where who can make any sense out of it. But you know, at the same time, it's so fantastic that we can't touch it. There's a place in here where, you know, it's not that far away. I don't want to turn it into something that, well, you know, Jesus can work miracles, but, you know, we're just people. I mean, Osensei and Jesus were just people, you know, mothers at least. Anyway, so. Less than you think. You need to do less than you think, and you have more than you know. Anything else on this exercise?
I'm looking back to some places on the web.
Yeah, just as you're saying, you really try to direct the thing on the first and not the second. It makes quite a difference.
Yeah, and did it make a difference the first and middle?
No.
We've got it! You should want it. So, I mean, again, what I'm looking at is how we can take something that's not particularly a big deal, and we can blow it into a big deal. You know, I can't tell you about a school class having a $10 part of the paper. When I look at it now, to get that bent out of shape over something so little, and it's like, well, it's not like I can't understand that I can get upset about it. I'm just saying, what could it be? Was that really what I wanted to be doing with my key? The tone I want to be generating, you know, the kind of quality of energy in the dojo, or the smell of cigarettes in the room, is that what I wanted my life to be full of? So why did I keep going into it? Well, I didn't know that. I just did it unconsciously. I grew up, my dad got mad, that's what I grew up, I got mad. I thought it was being mean. I don't, you know, whatever. Just some misunderstanding, some stupid misunderstanding, but as I started to catch, I thought, well, now I can get upset if I want to, and I do. I don't have the same feeling of like complete helplessness to it. Or it isn't like, even while I'm doing it sometimes, I can't laugh at myself. And you know, I'm kind of into the, you know, if you've ever done one of those, you look back on it 3 weeks later and laugh about it. Get another joke on. Two, okay, 3-1.
Thank you.
this moment.
See, I mean, what's so bad about this?
Mike's being caught.
And I think, again, I mean, we, for a month, something like that might happen. Years, something like that. Now, I admit, there are a lot of other things that happen too, but we're here now. And the movies are making about what goes on. Because, again, if that's really what we're looking for, can we do real slow motion? And slower than what you think. So why couldn't we? You know what I mean?
Ooh!
if that's what the situation really called for, you like. You know, that those moves are so close in danger to what we're doing. It would take so little to arm the system. Once you're in that state where your key's flowing, instead of like this, people are pretty vulnerable in a few spots. But again, do we want to spend our time looking? Let's see, where are all the vulnerable spots? Let's see, how bad could I, what could I? A little time, a little. Good capability to have, you know, but we really can't do that with each other. Most of us aren't here for that anyway. The majority of us love the fact that there's a community here, so, you know, we got to take good care of each other so we can hang out together. I'm probably beating a drum here, because I like music. But we keep doing things that are actually counter to what we want to be doing. We slip into a mode of being upset about a flat tire, and you pick your story.
Speeding fines.
Well, speeding fines now are $500 in this case. But even so, is getting upset going to do something for you? Wouldn't you rather just center and breathe and think about how you're going to make some money? You know, just being like this about it. So again, I'm just looking at. Are we really creating our lives the way that we want to? Do we even think about it? Or do we just live in a state where, oh God, you know, and we're always in reaction to things that we don't like? We don't have enough gratitude for what we've got. We don't think and dream beautiful thoughts and beautiful dreams and what we like and how we'd like to be. We don't tell people that we love them enough. We don't tell each other how much we've enjoyed being together enough. We could do that with our key. You know, or we could talk about the jerk down the street or what an asshole you are or, you know, or what you pick it. But it's just we slip into these unconscious places and we do with our lives something that we wish we hadn't done after it's over. And all it would take, you know, it's not that big a deal. Just notice that you're tight right now and you're probably pretty comfortable, but somewhere in your body there's some tension and you could let go of it if you want to or not. We're better? Great. There's probably still some you could let go if you want to or not. And I'm not talking about collapsing. I'm talking about a very positive key, but relaxed and fluid. Right? Okay. Last turn. Groups of three. Anything before we do that?
We feel between the three of us that we might almost have just touched on it. I don't know what it is, but when we came out, we were nice and calm, and then we looked about us and there was this frenzy. There was this massive happening everywhere. And we looked at each other and thought, we were quite pleased with our effort between ourselves. And something.
Good. So, again, I thought that Lloyd did pretty good yesterday over this call. Good, too, because I enjoyed that. Gilson. That's what I'm about. I mean, I guess some people might say, yes, you know, I'm teaching the martial arts. I'm not. I'm teaching the new skills. Yeah. Yeah, I think generally we tend to make mountains out of molehills, and God knows we've been in mountains.
A picture of how a spiral moved, and these didn't always go like that.
so spiral wasn't the right word. I said, okay, what word do you like? She said, serpentine. What I would say is, as you start this, there is no movement in the outside. What Dean was pointing to is exactly right. But if you'll press into it a bit, stay relaxed and do not move the outside. And so like you realize that it's either choosing, I'm going to exaggerate, it's either going this way or it's going this way. It'll have a direction to it. And rather than just, harmonizing with the key, and not just kids, but in this case, there's something much, much, much finer or more subtle going on, and you start to feel it now. Keep going, and feel kind of want to move over here. All right? So, don't mind it seems to take a little longer than you think it should. Don't mind it, mind it. But the trouble is that we kind of want to take that first spiral and then turn into a big one. Then they're just going to fall down quicker and get up quicker and fall down quicker and get up pretty soon to your turn again. You're going to get tired. So, really emphasize this. Fall. So, you probably have to give up key on the Gare spirals. You have to give up your idea what spirals are. And just start, just going to start. There's going to be a little bit of motion there. You're going to start to move with it. Now, the encouragement that I have, see, it's like, if he doesn't grab on, and he doesn't put some key into it, well, I think it's still true, but I don't have any feedback. So, I really need my partner. Help me do this. Alright? And don't mind those ones where you're going, and this happened. Message. Okay, that was you thinking about it. The limited you trying to do it. Did you ever hear Mr. Cohen had a nice analogy? He said, kind of like Bob's 20-room mansion, we live in about 2 rooms of it. Mr. Tohei's was like an iceberg. There's this little bit that floats above the water, beneath the water, there's this massive amount. And most of us live in this part. And there's actually all this more that we don't know about or don't think about. It's there, and we could have access to it. And that's what I see going on here. We're touching energy at another dimension. And then we say, oh yeah, I can see where it's going to go. And not in it anymore. You know, we're blending with their energy or something like that. So I can see what's going to happen, and we're not blending anymore. So don't throw it. Or as Mr. Salatoni used to say, don't throw it. Just blend. Or in this case, just spiral. And the thing we talked about yesterday, the desire to take control, that just overwhelming, uncontrollable urge, stronger than sex, you know? Just take control. It's here, watch it. And then know that, you know, it's you're right. It's right. There is something that's in control. Right hand I wanted to see. So it's there, and all I can do is notice it, because if I notice it, then I start to relax. And then what I want to say is this, the gradualness with which this grows. I'm really trying right now to slow it down. Yeah, in Aikido technique, what we want to do is go from that in, you know, billionth of a second, whatever it's going to be. But don't do that now because you'll miss this training. So, spiral. So I use that word to remind you, don't get fixed. How it's supposed to move. still keen on the garbage. So when you get hung, oh, it's fire with the figure, figure, well, that was just the way you experienced it. But once you get there, it's king on the guard. Some of them spiral in, some of them, you know, God knows what. Now, there's no, and that's why I say there's a limit to practicing technique. Because, you know, how many of these different variations of the spiral can you practice in, you know, a mere 80 years? But if you catch this quality, you can practice wherever the spiral leads you. Because, you know, you may have one that goes like this, you may have one that goes like that, and yours may not go like that, so you don't need to practice that. You need to practice yours. Not that it would hurt to learn anyone else's culture. I mean, you somehow let peaceful reconciliation means the completion of your bestowed mission. Not somebody else's bestowed mission, not somebody else's idea of your bestowed mission. So. All right. If you can catch this feeling a little bit, well, I'd like to take it, you know, not only a giant step, quantum leap into the next, you know, skip over all the middle steps here, and take it to the next level of this, you know, another dimension of this practice. And what I want to do is to say, well, you know, I had to kind of push into it, make sure that your ki was really touching or something like that. Again, we're working through the physical because we want to make the experience tangible, and I have a lot of little red marks on my wrists too. And it wouldn't be nice to just stop grabbing your wrist for a little while. So let's go into the energy flow. So what I would say to you, in the same sense that we did this and we felt tangible flow, regardless of what attack Dean had in mind, as soon as his ki lands on me, as soon as he had any intent towards me at all, provided my ki is not pulled back, provided my ki is there feeling